A lot of advertisers and business owners get confused when trying to set up their first Google Ads campaign. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up your first Google Ads campaign the right way. Hello, and thanks for joining in. My name is Uzair, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up your first Google Ads search campaign the right way. Now, the Google Ads interface is a fairly complicated interface. Lots of bells and whistles, functions, buttons, and options to use when setting up your Google Ads. So in this video, I'm going to simplify it and take you step by step as to how you can quickly and easily set up your first campaign in Google Ads. So when you're in your interface. Now, if you don't see this interface, you probably are in the Google Ads Express. So you need to switch it over to the expert mode. Once you go in here, you will see this interface where you will have all campaigns which will say here on the top left hand corner, search, display, shopping, video, and smart. So we're gonna look at the search campaign in this one. You click on the plus button and then new. Now, here's where a lot of you get a bit puzzled and confused. It asks you to select a goal for this campaign. And there's one over here which says create a campaign without the goals guidance. What this means is you're going to get all the features which Google Ads has to offer, whereas in some of these ones you don't get all the full features and functionality like the bidding options, etc. So in the past when I've uploaded videos and I've gone live on YouTube, I've always said that whenever I set up a campaign, I tend to use this option without the goals guidance. Now I'm going to show you a couple of things what the difference is. So let's say we go to sales, and obviously this is a search campaign, so we're not going to cover all the other options, but let's keep it to search. Now you see over here you've got select the ways you'd like to reach your goal: website visit, phone call, store visit, app downloads. But what about a conversion, like someone submit a lead form, or you want somebody to fill in a form to get you a lead? It doesn't give you that option, but this does not mean that you cannot set up your conversion tracking or get leads from your campaign. It's just the way this is set up. So if you have got the leads selected as the goal option, and then you go to search, you find all of a sudden instead of four options over here, you've got the option for lead form submissions as well. If you were to select this one, this does not mean we are not setting up a conversion. We will be setting up the conversion tracking. That's completely different to this goal conversion. In the create a campaign without the goals guidance, we now get three options, but that really doesn't matter to me because I will be setting up my conversions afterwards. So you don't need to worry too much or stress about it, because you can check this in and you can put in your website address and your phone number, because then it's going to look at your website and will recommend you the keywords, etc. I put these in. So now I get all the features and benefits of the Google Ads interface. So you first of all put in your campaign name, whatever it may be, and then this is really important. You do not want to have the display network selected over here, because a display network is completely a different network altogether compared to the search network. The search network is where someone goes to Google and puts in or types in the search term which they are looking for, whereas the display network is third-party websites where you have the opportunity to place your ads on over 3 million websites and apps. So you don't want to muddle the data. It's a different campaign altogether. So if you want it to go on display, then you would just select it like this. So for this search campaign, I'm going to keep it unchecked. Now you can switch on the search partner networks and see how the campaigns are performing. If it is for a fairly local business and in a local area, so you don't have a lot of traffic on there, then Google is going to put up your ads on Google search partner sites. I tend to take it off to begin with. If I find that I don't get enough impressions, then I'll come back in and I'll take this off. Then you select your options, whether you want to go to all countries, your local country or your local area. You have the options over here to either select a radius around where you are, or you can put in certain cities, towns, or areas. So if I were to go in around me, where I am, now I can see that this is the area where Google is going to run my ads. So it's a great way to put my ad out in all the surrounding areas where I am, because if I don't select this option and I put in the location, then I need to put in all the other ones, Milton Keynes, Bletchley, Aylesbury, Luton, all of these other ones. Whereas over here, I don't need to worry too much about it now. It is all covered. I save it. And now I can see you've got, but you can also have multiple areas as well. So let's say if I go up north a bit and I want to run a campaign for Peterborough. Now there's two ways you can do this. You can either put them in the same campaign or have a separate campaign for a separate location. So you can split the budget for both these locations, because if this one is eating up all the budget, then you won't get much traffic over there. If I save it, you'll see I've got two of these locations here. So I'm going to take one out. I'll keep it simple. Then under location options, you want to select this second one. Although it says here the first as the recommended, you want people in or regularly in your targeted location. Then it will only show people in your location and not people outside of your location who show an interest in your targeted location. And this one is fine where it says recommended. English is good for me, or whichever language you want. Audiences, you don't want to worry too much about it. I'll cover this in a separate video where we can use some advanced strategies to see what kind of audiences are coming to our website and the type of call to action they are taking. Budget, you need to put in. Just put in whatever you want. You can either have a single budget or you can have a shared budget where you have one budget and you can apply it to multiple campaigns so you don't go over your daily budget. Now here's where you will find many people think that, are these the only bidding options available for me, which is conversions, conversion value, clicks and impression share. I tend to run my campaigns initially as manual campaigns and then switch over to smart bidding once I've got enough data or conversions in my campaigns. Now here's something which Google has put in: select a bid strategy directly, not recommended. And then in there you will find all the other, these are all smart bidding, whereas I want to go manual, and then it's hidden right at the bottom over here. You can have enhanced CPC, so it will Google is going to bid a lot more aggressively in front of those who it thinks are likely to convert, and bid less who it thinks not likely to convert. I'm going to check this off for now. So I put my manual CPC. So obviously the bids will be set up at either the keyword level or the ad group level. Then you've got this little button here as well, which is for conversion tracking. So once you've set up your conversions, you can set up all your account level conversions. You may have one or more conversions set up in your account. So it could be a form submit, it could be a call to your business, or somebody downloaded a PDF or something like that. So you could include all the conversions, or you can choose a specific conversion action just for this campaign, and then you can check off which one you want from here, whether it's a lead form or a call to your website. For this video, I'm going to keep it at account level. So all the conversions, anyone clicks on my website, on my ads, comes through to my website, they take a conversion action, it will be included over here. Ad rotation. You ideally want to have multiple ads in every ad group. So you ideally want to have two extended text ads and one responsive search ad. And then you can either optimize, prefer best performing ads, or do not optimize, which will not rotate the ads indefinitely. So what the difference between the two is, if one is performing very well, the other one Google doesn't run. So you don't know whether the second one, which is not running at all, would perform better than the first one or not. So what you want to do is to test it first and do not optimize, run both or two or three ads at the same time so that each one is run equally, and then you can decide which one is performing, which one isn't performing. Then you have got all the ad extensions, which I will cover in a separate video. And once you have reached at the bottom, you save and continue. So the good thing about this setup is you cannot miss anything. Google has made this interface in such a way that you keep scrolling down as long as you click and don't miss this little settings button. Then you can keep putting in all that information and set this up. So for example, over here, which I did miss, you can set up your start date if you want the campaign to set a start on a particular date and end on a particular date. So this is quite handy, because if this campaign is for a particular offer or a campaign, for example, Christmas, you don't want the offer to run into the new year. So you can select a date to end the campaign on the 31st of December or on the 26th of December or whenever. Ad schedule, whether you wish to run your campaigns every day, weekdays, weekends, or on a particular day from certain time. So if you want to run Monday to Fridays, only during office hours, which could be 9 a.m. till 5 p.m. Where is it? And on the weekend, let's say you are open from 9 till 12, so you can quite easily schedule it like this. So as you keep scrolling down and entering all the bits and of information or selecting what you want, you then reach the bottom where it says save and continue. And that's how you save your campaign. Once you save it, you'll see that campaign pop up under your campaign tab, and then you'll be taken to your ad group setup. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you would like to learn more about Google Ads, I go live on YouTube every day, every weekday, I should say, at 4 o'clock UK time, where I go through tutorials and workflows as well as answer any questions you may have. So hope you can join in. It's free to join in and there's no sign up required as well. So thanks for watching this video and being here. I truly appreciate it and I look forward to seeing you in my next one. Bye for now.